Yo. Okay, so the best way to go about doing what we're going to be doing today is to have the quad view. So Alt W will bring this up, and we got to do a couple things to prepare the hands first. So I'm going to unhide what I've made here, and this is going to represent my rocket launcher. And on this guy here, I'm going to add NURMS. So I'm going to scroll down, click on Use NURMS on this guy. Adjust his hands a little bit so his thumbs are a little bit longer. Okay. And now I'm going to convert this into an editable poly. And now this is what this looks like. All right, so now what I'm going to do is put some bones in this guy, and I'm going to first click on the hand. Go to this button here, click Effect Pivot Only, click Center to Object, center up the anchor point so we can center this up. Okay, so now press W, and then on these position X, Y, and Z down here, right click on the up and down arrows to center this to the world, and then you're going to position this for his hand. Now we're going to hide the weapon. Now we're going to put in bones, and we're going to use a couple of these views. So what you want to do is go up to Animation, go down to Bone Tools, and I'm going to zoom in here, and I'm going to press F3 on this hand here so I can see what I'm doing. I'm going to create bones, I'm going to zoom in on the hand, and I'm going to start at the root of the bone, finger, thumb, and I'm going to go out. So I'm going to left click again at the knuckle, left click again at the end of the thumb, and then right click. I'm going to do the same thing here, starting right about where these come together. So I'm going to go here, and I'm going to left click, and then where the knuckle would be, where I want it to rotate, left click again, go to the end of the finger, left click, right click. I'm going to do that again for these. Right click. Left, 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 right. Left, 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 right. I'm being very careful not to extend the bones past where the whole mesh becomes one object, where the fingers, I'm putting them where the fingers sort of start to branch off. And now I need to put one in the hand, and I'm going to go from the hand out. So I'm going to go all the way to the end of the hand. I'm going to right click now. Now I'm going to adjust the position of the bones. So I'm going to make sure that this blue button is off. I'm going to click that so it's no longer on, and I'm going to click it to get rid of it for now. And I'm going to expand this window, Alt-W here, and now I'm going to click on this button that says All, and I'm going to click Bones. So now, where are Bones? So now all I'm doing is affecting the bones here. And I'm going to sort of rotate the bend of the fingers, because if you don't do that, the computer will determine where you bend the finger on its own. So I'm going to rotate up these bones here. It's kind of tricky to see what's going on, so maybe if you want to press F3, although that's kind of even trickier. So I'm going to rotate up where a finger would bend, just at the middle knuckle. And I'm going to do the same thing here, up a little bit, and then down, and then I'm going to do the same on the thumb, leaving the hand bone alone. And this might be a little weird. You might need to go up here to view and change this to local, which changes the angle that you're rotating this to, the specific rotation gizmo of the object that you're looking at, and then change this back to view. Sorry, not view, but world. All right, and that should be good. Now I'm going to press F3 to see if any of the bones are popping out of the hand. It doesn't look like they are, so now I'm going to click on bone and go to all so I can click the hand. I'm going to go up here, I'm going to add skin, and now I'm going to click add, and I'm going to expand all the bone options, because you have to do this to select all the bones. It's kind of monotonous. I'm going to select the bottom bone, hold shift and click on the top bone, then I'm going to click select. It's going to add all the bones in here, but I forgot to do a step, so I'm going to hit control Z to undo that. I'm going to delete the skin modifier. I forgot to do one thing. I'm going to press F3, and now I'm going to click on the nub bone of the thumb. I'm going to go to animation, IK solver, HI solver, and I'm going to click on the bottom bone. So now I might want to do this too, click all and go to bone so I don't put this on something accidentally. So now I'm going to click the nub of this finger, and I'm going to repeat with the following fingers, going to IK solver, HI solver, clicking on the first bone. Same thing here. Now what this does is give me a little handle. I'm going to change bone to all, and I'm going to move this and see. This is how a finger is going to move once I move it. So now I can change this back to all if I haven't already. Click on the hand, go back, go to the modifier list, type SKIN for skin, click enter on skin. I'm going to go to add to bones, and then again, this is where I'm going to monotonously open up the bones, making sure they're all open, clicking the top, holding shift and clicking the bottom, click select. Now I'm going to press F3 to get out of this, and now it's not perfect, but it'll do since we used a low poly model. I'm going to unhide all, and now I'm going to start to wrap these fingers around the best I can. Down and then over. So do that for the rest of the fingers. The best you can. And if you get a finger that does this, you might want to go back and add a little more geometry in there, adjust the position of the bones. I might just kind of fake it until it starts to look bad and leave it alone like that and just kind of leave it there. Or you can go back and fix the geometry of the hand. In the spirit of saving the length of this video, that's what I'm going to do, is just leave it at that. And that looks hideous. So another thing is maybe just kind of adjust the hand so and once you get the hand sort of positioned where you want it, you can convert that into an editable poly. Okay, so you could probably, on something like this, use soft selection in the vertices. And try to fix it with soft selection, maybe FFD, and do the best you can. And then when the hand looks all funky like this, maybe try adding another NURBS to it or something. And then, if you want, you can add FFD to this and pull out some depth. This hand looks really flat. But then again, we're only going to be looking at it from an angle like this. So do the best you can. And that's it.